Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Saloni, aka Moody Moo on social media. I'm a full-time illustration artist. That means I draw for a living. In today's video, we're gonna talk about the mistakes I made when I started out as a freelance illustrator, as a full-time freelance illustrator. I'd like to think of them as lessons more than mistakes. While I'm all up for letting people make their own mistakes and learning their own lessons, I also think that it wouldn't hurt to warn you or share my own experiences with you in advance. Or in other cases, maybe if you're already making these mistakes, I want you to know that you're not alone and that most of us have made these mistakes and it's completely okay to do that. So let's begin. Number one, not believing in myself enough. So this is a big one, but it is also very common. It happens to the best of us, not having faith in ourselves, especially because we have chosen a career so unconventional, which is not very common. So it's easy to lose faith in yourself, but please remember, it's really, really, really important to build that self-confidence, to build that faith in your own self and your own art. And you know how that's gonna happen? One is having cheerleaders around you. That is your close people, people who believe in you, people who encourage you and motivate you. Have such people around, hang out with them as much as possible. Another thing which is really important is keep making art. Make terrible art, make bad art, but just keep creating every single day. Even on those days when you don't believe in yourself, still make art. Don't stop creating. And eventually you'll get the drill, eventually you'll get better at it, and that's how you will build your self-confidence. Second one is not reaching out to people, not networking enough, not sending out emails, taking initiatives. This was another mistake that I made. I didn't do it enough. Although this one time I did reach out to Mark and Angel, they are life coaches. And these were people I really, really looked up to. One fine day, I just wrote an email to Mark and Angel and I told them that, you know, I would really like to collaborate with you in any way possible. I am an illustration artist. I really like what you guys do for a living. It would be great if you could just give me any chance to work with you in whatever way possible. Guess what? They replied to my email and they did give me an opportunity to work with them on a book project. It was a digital book. It was a big deal to get this opportunity to work with people I had admired all my life. We still keep in touch on Instagram and they're still accessible. They're more accessible to me now because we worked on a project together, so I can easily reach out to them. I did that once and I got a great opportunity. So I cannot emphasize enough on how important it is to reach out to people. Given the social media culture, especially now, people are more accessible than they used to be before social media. So it's really, really very easy to do this. All you have to do is just send out an email, write to people who you want to work with, make notes of what your expertise is, and find people that you think might need what you have. And that's how you create necessity. Like, for example, maybe reach out to someone with a blog. Maybe they're using stock photos for their blog or website. You can reach out to them, write an email saying, I'm an illustration artist and I think I can really help enhance your website aesthetics with my illustrations. Why don't we collaborate on this? And I think it's going to be great for both of us. The most important thing is to make it a win-win situation. Never know what opportunity you might get and what kind of people you might get to work with. It wouldn't hurt to just send out an email to people. Third, undervalue my work. Charge people for the time and energy and effort that you have invested in that project. Stop working for free or for exposure. Don't do that. I even undercharge people for projects just so that I don't lose out on whatever small amount they're paying me, but that is how they take advantage of your inability to ask for what you deserve. So don't do that. Don't work for free, because once all of us as artists and freelancers stop doing that, stop working for free, they'll be left with no option but to pay artists what they deserve. Exposure and favors are not paying our bills. Fourth, comparing my work to other artists. Our uniqueness, our individuality is our main USP. So comparing your art to others' art is futile. You don't got what they got and they don't got what you got. You can admire their work and be inspired by them, yes, but beating yourself up for not being like others or not being as good enough is a waste of time. Let others' work be a driving force for you to do better every day. There's enough room for everyone. There's enough room for all kinds of artists. Don't let this bring you down. Instead, use it to stay motivated and make more art every day. Number 5, taking social media comments too seriously. People have bad things to say about the best of people and the best of things. This is what idle, insecure minds do. In the beginning, I used to get affected really very easily. Being insulted on a public forum isn't easy to deal with. I get that. I used to play these negative remarks over and over in my head on a loop. Now I realize how silly that was and what a waste of time that was, because you know what I could have been doing instead of thinking about those people or those comments? I could have been building new skills. I could have been creating more art. I could have been practicing my skills. I could have been signing up for an online course or a workshop, doing anything else than overthinking. Just know that it's not you, it's them just projecting their own insecurities and unhealed traumas on you. You can either choose to block these haters or just ignore. I often do the latter because it's not helping anyone. Haters gonna hate, but creators gonna create. So create more art instead of sulking and overthinking, because it's a waste of time. Number 6, seeking validation, constant validation for my work on social media. So I would make a piece of content and post it online, be really excited about posting it online on social media, and the response it would get would not be as good as I'd expected, and this would upset me sometimes. Gradually, I realized that my art is what I make to express myself, to express my thoughts and ideas, and I cannot let that be taken away from me just because of some algorithm. Art is something which is very subjective. Some people might prefer blue stripes and some people might prefer red dots. Some people prefer Bollywood masala movie. Some people prefer an artsy Oscar winning film. So you cannot let social media have that much power or number of likes determine what your art means to you. Of course, you can check your analytics and check how much engagement what post is getting, but that cannot affect your work or your ability to make stuff. In the end, all you have to ask yourself is, did I become an illustrator for followers and number of likes, or did I become an illustrator because I want to do it and I want to create art? That's the main question you gotta ask yourself. Number 7, not maintaining a digital or tangible notebook for my ideas. I cannot tell you how many ideas I have lost in my mental clutter because I did not jot it down in a physical book or a digital diary. That's a lesson learned. I now make it a point to jot down all my ideas whenever, as and when I get them, in my digital diary, which I maintain on Notion. It's a great app. It has a mobile app, it has a desktop app, and everything gets synced really easily, and it's accessible to me whenever I want to. You can check that out as well. But maintain a digital or physical notebook for ideas. Just note it down, even if you might not want to make something out of it on that day, but maybe in the future you might just want to go back to it, and it could probably help you create something great out of that idea. So please maintain a notebook for ideas. Number 8, quitting my day job before making proper income out of freelancing. This was the most important lesson I learned. So you've newly discovered your love for drawing and illustrating, and now you want to pursue it as a career, and you're doing great on social media. You're getting a lot of followers from posting your art online. That is great. Keep doing that, but do not quit your day job. Keep your day job until unless you have started getting projects that pay you enough to sustain your livelihood. Don't be too quick to quit your day job. If you want, you can always switch to another job that allows you more time to pursue your freelancing on the side, but just don't be impulsive. Number 9, lack of discipline. Just because we are our own bosses and we have no one else to report to does not mean that we take it for granted. Have a fixed schedule. Commit to creating art every day for a few hours. Commit to building new skills, who posting on social media every day, because social media and your Instagram is like your digital portfolio. Building audience on social media is really going to help you in the future. This audience is going to bring you more brand collabs in the future. This audience is going to be your target group in the future when you have an online store. These are the people who are going to buy your art. These are the people who are going to talk about your art. So commit to creating and posting content on social media and creating art every day as well. Do not take it for granted just because you're a freelancer. You need to maintain a work-life balance. So these were all the mistakes, not all the mistakes, but of what I can remember, these were the mistakes I made and lessons I learned. I hope these help you in your career as a freelancer, freelance illustrator. And if you have your own experiences and mistakes, lessons learned, whatever related to freelancing, and please share them in the comments. You never know who you might be helping. And if you have any other freelancing related questions you want to ask me, please drop them in the comments as well. I will get back to you very soon. Also, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with whoever you think might need it or needs to watch it. Subscribe to my channel. I'm trying to create more videos for my YouTube channel, so please subscribe and like, share and comment, all of that. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye.